They were literal clods, man. Nobody's actually died. Who are you doing that for?
Land's got no tact.
Do too.
Is about atoning.
Riku, what you saying there?
Why are we seeing them off? I know they were only hollow vessels. But ultimately, we chose to fight and kill them. And nothing can change that fact. Even if there's no one to actually see off, we have to atone for that.
In nutshell.
Oh, I see.
Atonement, huh?
Hey, is Izzard okay with this? It's kinda...
Yeah, he doesn't mind.
Alright, guess you're all weirdos. Still, kinda strange. I wonder when it all started.
I couldn't tell you exactly when, but I would surmise it started out as a kind of process for the upkeep of the world.
Sounds like a crazy kind of process. This is all going way over my head.
Quite simple, actually. It gives a sense of security, lets you think your dead friends are looking out for you from above, alleviating feelings of guilt and of loss. That's how I understand it.
Yeah, okay, but ain't there plenty of people who don't care about that?
What matters is that it is there. You don't need to pay attention. You don't need to do anything. But the way it is designed, if you think about it, it just works. We are told our life is born from the Queen, and to the Queen it returns. However, that's only if you make it to your homecoming. But what of the others? What of those who fall on the battlefield? Nobody knows. Where do they go? Seeing motes rise into the sky serves to dispel any unease. You end up believing, well, they're going somewhere.
But where is somewhere? The Queen's place?
No clue.
You what, mate? That's kind of non-committal for you.
Disappointed?
Nah, not fussed.